Behavior analysis has nothing to do with autism. It's just something that is effective when used with that population when you're using it as a process. Like, we're usually like trying to address like challenging behavior or like communication deficits in people with autism. It's been used for tons of other things as well. I like to like orient myself to articles that like are not like autism specific. Like, so things like you can find articles out there how people have used behavior analytic principles to reduce graffiti, improve work performance in company like organizations, things like that. So what does define ABA? It's a scientific approach. It's not a thing, it's not a procedure. Like, it's an approach to problem solving, right? It involves using the scientific method. Use like single subject case design, you know, like reversals, things like that. And like, we just try to change things in a meaningful way. That's what defines behavior analysis.
Yes, Freddy. Yes, Freddy. Yes, Freddy.
Behavior analysis doesn't have anything to do with like a specific disability. It's not like a particular type of problem. It can be used for anything. It can be used across like lots of like areas. Like, I was in a classroom and like somebody had like, oh, like our ABA, this is our ABA. And it's like a little box and it says ABA in like black Sharpie on the outside. I was like, that's where it's been this whole time? When I like work, when I train people, my goal is to not make them into somebody who works with people with autism. I want to make them into a scientist. Like, I want them to like kind of follow like those guidelines. Like, I want them to like approach any kind of a problem as if they're a scientist and they can work with any population. Because like, if you only learn the things on the task list, like, you end up becoming like somebody who just has a bag of tricks. Right. You don't understand like the concept behind it. You're not approaching it in a scientific manner. Like, you just, there's somebody like, all right, let's try DRO. Like, let's try FCT. Like, you just like throw stuff at it. And I think that like the people who are experts, the people who are leaders, are the ones who are not approaching it as something that you do with the population. It's somebody like, this is how I solve problems. Like, how can I solve this in a behavior analytic way? Like, this is a kid from my dissertation. This is years ago. Kid had a diagnosis with ADHD, not autism. He was a young kid. He was the meanest kid I ever met in my life. Four-year-old kid. He called me a stupid shit, like, every day for an eight-week program. And, like, I was a graduate student. I wasn't exactly confident at the time, so I started to believe it after a while. I was like, Bob, you're a stupid shit. I was like, maybe I am. So he had lots of social skills deficits, needless to say. And he also engaged in intense stereotypical behavior. And he was on a very high dose of Concerta, which is a stimulant medication. It's Ritalin. It's an extended release version of Ritalin. So we did an analysis. Like, I was interested in play behavior, whether or not stimulants affected play. And we did a double-blind placebo control, so the people who were watching him had no idea what he was taking, and he didn't know what he was taking, because he was just taking things from like different bottles that looked like the same pill. And we took data on whether or not he participated during structured tasks and structured activities like a kickball game or open recess, like free-for-all recess, like do whatever they want, like Lord of the Flies crap. And we took data on whether or not they played and whether or not they engaged in stereotypical behavior. So just bear with me. So this is his kickball game. So game participation, when he was on placebo, he was not participating a lot. Like, he's like looking over at me like, stupid shit. And he's like calling me names, and I'm just like, he wasn't engaging in a ton of stereotypical behavior. On the 36 milligram dose, it's a little bit better. Like, he's paying attention. Like, he's actually looking at the ball, like not getting ready to be beamed. Stereotypical behavior increases a little bit. On the 54 milligram dose, he's like a rock star. Like, he's actually paying attention most of the time. Stereotypical behavior's through the roof. So then during open recess, so basically we had like this quad that was open and we just had like a line of students like on the one open end to make sure that they didn't run away. So on the placebo dose, he was playing the entire time, hardly any placebo. Like, he was playing a lot while on the 36 milligram dose of Concerta. Stereotypy popped up a little bit. On the 54 milligram dose, he wasn't playing anymore. And he was engaging in tons of stereotypy. So what this kid was doing is, like, while the other kids were playing, like, he was sitting on the sidewalk, banging a stick and chewing on his fingers till they bled. So this is behavior analysis. Nobody had autism, like it was, like he was a little kid. It was an approach like to like address an issue. Like he got taken off the 54 milligram dose. He ended up being on the 36 milligram dose after this.